let's start this tutorial by saying I'm an idiot. So I thought I was going to be clever and do a comparison of the 9800X 3D versus the 7800X 3D and use RAM at 8000 megatransfers at CL38. Yeah. Needless to say, in the future, when the test bench is refreshed, I will be downgrading to 6400 as the standard. So it did work, but it took literal hours on multiple tests and balancing the RAM and doing the tests over and over and over. The results were not surprising in gaming. I will bring out another review to show you exactly what the generational improvement was, but we are looking at a 5 to 10% generational improvement on FPS, which is nothing massive and what most people noted. The first thing that I did do was put the two CPUs side by side, and I'll put it in front of you now so that you can see what the difference on the generations are and what my predictions were before going into testing. The first notable difference is the architecture in which we've moved from Zen 4 to Zen 5. The socket remains the same at AM5, but the processing node, or nanometers, has gone from 5 nanometers to 4 nanometers. Cores and threads are the same at 816. Base clock speed is another big change because we've seen the increase from 4.2 as base to 4.7 on the 9800X3D, and boost clock speed has gone from 5 to 5.2, noting where we are getting some of our power, but not all of it. I'll explain that just now. Another note is the L1 cache, which is a per core cache, has gone from 512 to 640 kilobytes. L2 caches remained the same at 8 megabytes, L3 caches remained the same at 96 megabytes, and the TDPs have remained the same at 120 watts. Both can be overclocked, but now for the main one. The max temperatures have increased from a set 89 degrees to 95 degrees, giving the CPU a bigger bandwidth to be able to perform. Now, 95 may sound high, but it's actually pretty standard in what you would expect for a high-end CPU to be doing at capacity. But that extra 6 degrees, we will see what it opens us up to now. The launch date MSRP, we have 449 on the 78 and a 479 for the 98, so pretty similar. The release date you can see for yourself. The current price in Rand is 11,499 for the 9800X3D, and for the 7800X3D is 10,999. Obviously, this is all going to depend where you shop. And the current price in USD is pretty much identical at 479 and 476, on which I checked this on eBay. Any American watchers, please feel free to comment on where the best price for this would be in the States. Now let's look at the actual test results. Okay, on to test time and to see how the PCs were set up. As mentioned, they were identical, the only difference being the motherboard, in which for the 7800X3D, we used my standard ASRock X670 Ti Carrara, and for the 98, we used the MSI X870 Tomahawk Wi-Fi. Starting off with Cinebench R23, we hit a 22559. Now you can look at the rest of the data, but this is more a comparison on generation versus generation, so bear that in mind as we go through the results. This is a 28.32% increase on generational performance on multi-core. If we look at single core, we hit a score of 1983 versus the 1782 that I had previously. This is a 17.51% increase on generation. Cinebench 2024, less than what we saw on the multi-score of R23, but still a 25.12% increase, having a score of 1335 versus the 1067 of the 7800X3D. Then for single core performance, we had a 19.64% increase generationally, and this is a score of 134 versus the previous 112. Note that the 9800X3D outperformed the 7800X3D of 122 and the 14700K of 131. Performance test 11, I'm not going to go through all of the data, I'm just going to go through the highlights. We can see that it was a 15.35% generational improvement. Where we saw the biggest improvement is on prime numbers, so a lot more computing power there, 36.62%. We did see a minor decrease in encryption, nothing really to note, but we do see the mirror in what we saw in both Cinebenches on the single thread performance on MOPS, which was a 17.02% increase performance-wise. Something that I wanted to show was PC Mark just for overall productivity so that we could see if we had to compare these two as pure systems that one would work on, what would we expect? And that result came to 10.87. So not really that major and pretty much mirrored to what we saw in a lot of gaming test benchmarks, but the biggest improvement came in productivity, in which we hit a 12,121 versus the 10,758 of the 7800X3D. Blender was a massive increase of 27.95%, hitting a score of 325 versus the previous of 254. Massive note there because it's a huge improvement, but I will elaborate a bit more on that when we get to the stats because there is something important to note there. Geekbench just being put here for your edification, multi-core performance increased by 22.57 and single core a little bit better than what we saw in Cinebench, 21.87. Another important thing to note is what we're seeing on 3D Mark CPU. Now, anyone that's watched my previous reviews knows that I don't really like to use 3D Mark CPU as the information is processed more on an older generation of CPU. For example, in Intel, we have performance and efficiency cores, so the result can be skewed. But if we compare like for like, we had a 26.3% increase on performance. So we can actually use this data and we can see that the threads per core are doing a much more efficient job in their tasks. As I mentioned, we will redo the gaming performance and I'll give you all of that data. I will have it there comparatively. And we did note that from all other tests and the research that I've done, we noted 5 to 10%. But I did do TimeSpy overall and TimeSpy Extreme overall just to give us a gauge. And on TimeSpy, we hit a 6.6. And on TimeSpy Extreme, we hit a 9.84% increase on the 78 to 9800X3D. So pretty much affirming what we already know. On to the stats and where things get really interesting, because we're going to start off with temperatures. The temperatures were pretty much okay throughout all tests, except for Blender, which I did note. We hit 92, so close to that 95, and that is versus a 79. So that improvement that we saw on Blender generational improvement did come at the massive cost of a lot more heat output. On pretty much all the benchmarks, we saw increases until we moved on to TimeSpy and TimeSpy Extreme hitting 84 and 84. And what's important to note from this, from a gaming perspective, is you're not necessarily going to get higher temperatures in gaming for making the swap from 78 to 9800X3D. So the performance in gaming is increased, but still thermally efficient. And now where the big graphs come to play, power draw. Cinebench R23 pulled a 153 versus 84 on the 7800X3D. And we note this going all the way through every single test in which we saw wattage draws being sometimes double of previous generation. Again, this is to be expected because we are getting a lot more performance out of this chip. Frequency, we can brush over. It was pretty much mirrored at 5215 for the 9800X3D throughout all tests. The only anomaly is Blender actually was underperforming on the 7800X3D, which could explain some of the tests as well as the temperatures, but I reran this quite a few times and made sure everything was all right. It's just how the test runs, but it was similar to all the other submissions that I saw. So nothing much to note here, just that we did hit the 5200 promised on the 9800X3D. Onto the last thing, and that's putting in a graphical representation of all the increases from the tests that I did. You can pause here because I'm only going to talk about the overall excluding gaming and the overall including gaming. We can see that the overall excluding gaming and the gaming would only be 3D Mark in this regard, a 21.55% increase generationally, and including gaming a 19.33%. So you do the maths and figure out whether this is going to be the best purchase for you. However, I was dumbfounded by the massive increase that we saw here from AMD in actually pushing their CPU to be something seen a little bit more than just the best gaming CPU. Onto the conclusion, I was genuinely shocked by the general computing improvement made by AMD in just one generation. Yes, the overall gaming improvement does leave much to be desired, but what AMD has done is it says this is still gaming, but now it's so much more. It's now a much more balanced CPU overall rather than the pure specialist gaming it was before. Something to note, generally speaking, is that technology is supposed to get smaller, faster, and consume less energy as technology improves. So with that in mind, let's look. Is it faster? Check. Is it smaller? Well, no, it's going to be the same AM5. However, the nanometers have gone from 5 nanometers to 4 nanometers. And does it consume less energy? No, it doesn't. The performance increase and improvement that we noted did come from higher wattage consumption, which is something that I do want to note because it's something that we saw from Team Blue, where it was more power, more power, more power, more power.
More power.
We're superheating.
More power.
Intermix temperature 7,400 degrees.
More power.
8,000 degrees.
More power.
2,000 degrees above maximum.
More power.
She'll blow soon.
But before I get absolutely obliterated by the comment section, note that I am not making that comparison. It's not even close. The performance to wattage is very much within the realms of acceptance. It's just something that I want to put a pin in. And if you want further iteration, I have noted, unfortunately, and I do say this hesitantly, but on Team Blue, on some mobile chips, I have seen more wattage pull from mobile chips than on this full desktop 9800X3D, which has done a phenomenal result in general computing and outputs. Now, the big question comes in, should you get one? And there are two scenarios. The first one is for those still on AM4. Yes, I believe it's time to make the leap straight for 9800X3D. But I will say that I do believe that the 7800X3D is due for a price correction very soon because they are super similar in price. The second scenario is for those who are on the 7800X3D. Now, if you're just using this for gaming, the answer is no. But if you are looking for more general computing power and you do use that CPU or your setup for more general purposes, it might be worth upgrading and getting that 30-odd% increase in some performance benchmarks. Case in point would be for someone like myself who doesn't just use their PC for gaming. I use it for Excel spreadsheets, editing, general computing. And for me, it would be worth the swap out from the 7800X3D to the 9800X3D for those benefits alone. But I do want to know your points on what I just mentioned. Please put them in the comment section below. As a reminder, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It's really important, help grows the channel, and really helps me out a lot. So if you're feeling philanthropic today, please go and hit that share and subscribe. Well, subscribe, like, and share. Guys, hope you enjoyed the content. Looking forward to seeing you on the next one. Cheers. Goodbye.